Belgaum, GIT College. I'm Omkar. He's Aditya. Yeah, it's Belgaum now. He's Aditya, he's Rahul, and he's Ashish.
Hello, hello, hello.
Dhatua is the project name that we have chosen. This basically means reflection. The mind is like water. When it is agitated, it becomes difficult to reflect. But when allowed to settle, the mind gets space to reflect. Dependency is an inevitable part of the elderly. For them, the love and care is necessary to flourish and adapt to this new phase of life. Assisted living facility with their wide range of services provide the same with a senior housing solution for adults who are independent but at the same time need assistance. The journey is more important than destination. A pause in the journey is to appreciate the walk so far and achieve of life is important to understand the preciousness of time and life. This never-ending cycle of life needs to be reflected back to some point. The reflection can only be achieved if there is a peaceful and clear state of mind, keeping all the complexities and disturbances aside. The design ideology works on this, trying to incorporate elements to cater this need of mental peace. The site lies in the prime location of Belgavi, in the vicinity of the cantonment areas. The area chosen in Belgavi is Lakshmi Tekdi. That's the prime location. The site is isolated from the chaos but is near the city area. The site is surrounded by green spaces and residential areas with a magnificent view of the Western Ghats. This is the reach matrix that explains the site. The market, civil hospital, KLE road, CBT, railway stations and the respective areas, like everything comes under 10 km of radius from the site and is very immediately and easily accessible from the site. So we can't play from it, it's a video clip. These are few factors that we tackled in our design, like self-sustainability, local material, easy accessibility, sensitivity, connection to surrounding and climate response. We'll be elaborating these points in our further design. The zoning. This is the site layout with the contours, the sun path, then the wind direction. This is the segregation, how the site followed, like the public, semi-private, private, then the services part. The site then further got divided in a grid format. Then grid spatial organization followed in the same pattern. These were how the spaces emerged in the zoning after once we segregated the site in a grid format. And hence, this is how the master plan developed.
Hello, hello.
Yeah. The master plan is being entered from the eastern side. And there's a service entry provided on the northern side. This is the north. As this is the main road, which is 12 meter wide, and this is like a 9 meter wide secondary road. And as we enter, we have our reception office and visiting area and the meeting space at this part. Our entire site is divided into zones. According to the zones, the connectivity is done. The first zone is the reception area or the temple, which acts as the first node of the entire site. This node further goes on to the second node, which is the most important space in our entire design, which is the meditation space and the library, which is placed at the center of the entire site. Then there's a kitchen and dining place right next to the entrance area in this, this thing. And there's another service area provided like for the kitchen and dining space. Then the third important zone is the hospital and the care units, which is there, which is placed at the northeastern side, northeastern side of the site, and which is accessible from two sides. One from this side, which is south, and another is from the western side. The services and on-duty staff caretakers units are been placed at this site so that these can cater even the hospital and also the housing inmate units which are there provided. There is kitchen garden provided to the towards the western side so that these housing units have an easy accessibility to them. Entire nodes, all the four nodes which are there, which is the reception, meditation space, housing zone and the hospital, have visual connectivity of all the four nodes so that it is easy for them for accessibility. There's also a biogas plant in the entrance of our site, leading towards the reception space. The sculpture, meeting area and the visiting area, closed and semi-enclosed, pergola. Moving towards our main node, which is the meditation and library, placed at the center of the site, having visual connectivity from all the four zones, getting it a meditation. Moving towards the hospital or the care units which are there. Basically the housing and the care units have been separated in our design. The development of the housing hospital block is generally made by the grid format, and further breaking into a central void so that they have an easy distinct. Another thing is the deformation of the block to have a wind access and also for the circulation purpose. Then on the western side, there's a green facade placed so that, southern side, so that the hot air and the diffuse sunlight is been
accessed inside.
On the terrace, there's solar panels have been provided so that these can have a sustainability effect. Over here we can see the three major aspects which are there in our design. One is the green facade placed on the southern side, continuing to have solar panels placed on the terrace. Then the third thing is the internal courtyard, which are overlooked by all the spaces, the ICU units and the common room, which I'll be explaining in the plan. This is the plan. North is over this side. So our main entry was from here and my service entry was from this side. So overall entry for this zone is here, that is from western side to the hospital, which is also easily accessible for the housing units. And another entry is from this southern side, so that it is accessed by the people who are coming from outside. They can directly come from this side.
The reception area.
Okay. The access is from the gradual ramp provided from here, all the three sides, and entering to an internal courtyard which has been overlooked by these three zones of the hospital block. Okay, there are three zones in this block. Firstly, this is zone 1, where we can see the reception, waiting area and chief medical technicians, laboratory and procedure room, consultation rooms and all stuff. The second zone is the common ward. That is just a temporary ward, so that if any procedure are to be taken, they can happen over onto this block, and also a consultation room and a common toilet provided for them. Third main block is a ICU block, which have been placed at this side, having their own counseling and procedure room and their toilets accordingly. Green in built process is also been followed in the concept, so that the monotony is broken. Then the main hospital and the housing block have been separated in such a manner that the housing, the inmate people, like the elderly people, should have a different atmosphere other than the hospital cells which are there. This we can see as a stereotype linear arrangement of hospital block, hospital cells, which have been broken up to form an introvert space. Then further developing into an internal courtyard for them, and further fusion of the building block to have an air movement and circulation for them. Then staggering of this building block so that the linearity of the monotony is broken. Then the covering this entire block with pitched roof so that it can be used for rainwater harvesting. And an internal courtyard having a green in built. The vernacular architecture can be seen in this entire thing, so that they have their homely feeling and simple atmosphere. The interior has been provided with all the facilities which they have there, and also an homely feeling. Over here we can see all the other three major aspects, like the internal courtyard, which is an interactive space between these two inmate units, and also the like brightly lit spaces of the individual units, and the interaction of these two spaces, which is an interactive space and this is a private space, and also the gutters provided at the either side of the roof so that rainwater harvesting can be done, and also this water can be used for their kitchen gardening purpose and their further uses. Actually, there are six clusters of this, and this is a typical cluster plan if you see, and in this there are six inmate units. Each cluster has six inmate units, in which two are double bed and the rest four are single bed. And the access is like there are two entrances. One is the major, which is the main entrance, which has a wide ramp entering into the side, and another, which is a narrow ramp leading them towards the kitchen garden, and there are separate kitchen garden area. Garden over here is the most important aspect which we have tried to implement in our design, so that the self-sustainability concept is very well like adapted, so that these people who have their daily schedule, they have some extra activity in them, so that this all these vegetables and fruits which they self-produce can be consumed by them, like banana, chiku, mango, papaya. These are like
3 months.
In 3 months of cycle, this crops or vegetables and fruits can be grown. So it's not much to that thing. The library and the meditation space, which is placed in the prime node of the site, plays a very important role in their relaxation and also as the recreational space. This is the library area, then leading towards the ramp, which is leading them towards the meditation space, which is at the other level of the entire site, giving it as a privacy and also a kind of service. Going on to the meditation space, the play of light and shadow has been made to have their mental space. Element has been used as the vernacular architecture we see in houses. They have been using skylights as using earthen pots. They just used to slice the earthen pots and use them as the skylights. In this this, if we see, this is the library area, which is well lit because of high windows and because of its double height, it has its stack effect. And it plays very well in natural light and ventilation on the upper zone. Then coming down towards the meditational space, here the light which they have been like, light which is coming inside is of two types. First is the diffuse light coming from the jali wall. And the other is the focus light which is coming from the earthen pot, which acts like oculus-like structure, giving them a kind of focus to, so that they can sit there, meditate and kind of relax in their sight. And another aspect is the fountain which is at a cascade, water cascade which is used, so that it plays an acoustical element for their entire soothing process. This is the plan of the library which is accessed from this ramp, and this ramp which takes them towards the meditational space, and it is a gradual ramp so that there is no problem for them so that they can handle. This is the library area. The overall site.
Going back to the strategies here, we see that all the strategies are effectively applied in design. And absence of single strategy leads to the loss of essence in design. All strategies work in unison to make the design workable and design oriented. These are few factors that we tackled in the design. Self-sustainable, the kitchen garden at the periphery, fruit bearing trees as a landscape element, biogas that treats the kitchen waste and the waste from the garden and produces manure for the same in the kitchen garden. Solar panels as a source of electricity for the hospital unit. Rainwater harvesting again being a self-sustainable technique of saving water in the site. These are the three accessibility where meditation and library form the central node, which connected the four main nodes, that is the main reception, that's the entrance node, then the hospital node, then the housing node and the kitchen garden node, that's the landscape part. Then easy ramp access, throughout the spaces ramps are used to access, making it easy accessible for the handicapped crowd. Then the grid planning is evidently seen in the zoning as well as individual plans of the elements. As a part of climate response, green facade is used in the hospital block, which gives a diffuse sunlight inside the space and also becomes the heat buffer. Then the courtyard becomes an interactive space as well as a climate element in the housing cluster. Then the Mangalore tile are a local material available at the site and also act as heat buffer. Then the ground cover is a landscape element, how the heat is tackled. The main ideology before we started this design was to separate the inmate units from the main hospital block, just to give them a homely feel and a secured like lifestyle where they don't feel that they are in under some assistance. So we separated the inmate units and made them into the cluster, housing cluster. Then we preserved the existing trees which were actually there on the site and then zoned our site accordingly before we started it at an initial zoning level. These are all the factors that
the sensitivity tactic.
Section through all the spaces and nodes show the connection to the outside to inside. This is a section that cuts through the site, which covers almost the activity that comes to the site, that starting right from the parking, then to the reception and the meeting area, to the background the hospital facade, then the meditation and the library space that's cut down, then the housing cluster, then that slopes down to the kitchen garden. These are the pop-ups that show a detailed render of how the space enact actually in those sections. The space around helps you get out of peace of mind and clear it out of all complexities, helping the user reach euphoria and see a clear reflection of his past and relieve it. I would add up to this like, the past is where we live and future is where we belong. This is how we... Thank you. Yes, sir, this is the model covering meditation and the library center. Even the concept of the adhan pot and that light and the, even the jali light, that how it's taken from the water body, is covered in the model itself. This is the housing cluster that explains the roofing pattern and the gutter system, how we took down the water to the rainwater harvest plant. This is the overall model covering the circulation and the spaces to the scale.
Shows the circulation and the spaces of the entire site and the blocks.
So because there is already a water fountain cascade there, so there will be already a pump that will be generating the and circulating the water. So the same pump can
kitchen garden. This is the entire site. The white thing which we see is the hard hardscape, and the brown thing is also the is the softscape. And this actually is the sunken space where shown in this part. And this is the hospital block, which is entered from house service entry.
The meditation, and this is the jali wall where we welcome the different
visitors. Can just access from this area.
Regular access is limited.
So this part, and only this part.
Okay, that's the service entry.
And this entire six cluster of zones, it is also divided into male and female, so that.
So do you chair how do I reach?
So there is a ramp over here, but.
Anyways, I mean,
if I would like to see the model, the other one, the bigger
All
one.
Right. Any comments from?
Chalo.
So we'll start with you, Aditya, and we'll move on this side.
Very good effort and very good sort of research in terms of what you're doing. I especially liked the aspects about use building those green vegetable gardens and sort of fruits and all that, and having the PV cells on the top of the roof. But what I just kind of not really got my head around is basically why is the hospital or the healthcare facility not connected to the main area? It is connected from the ground floor level, but from the upper levels, I don't see any connectivity.
Actually, the hospital is just a single floor structure. The entire site, like the entire building, are just the single floor. It is not going vertically. And talking about the connectivity of housing and hospital block, they have been easy accessibility. Like, if I have to go to the hospital block, there's not... If I have to reach this block, there are two major connectivity. Project. Like one major can be from towards this side. This white shows the hardscape. The another thing can like they can travel from over here and reach this block. And this block can be only used like their whatever treatments and whatever they has to be taken can also happen in their housing blocks. Like if they have to provide a saline or something which is relevant to that, they can be placed in their inmate units and they. Even the housing and the hospital units can be collaborated.
Like the housing unit is designed such a way that a basic medication what a patient requires, as that help can be provided in his room itself. It's not a necessary part that he has to go till the hospital block.
That's fine. So the only one comment which I really like is basically because I was talking about dementia and sort of memory loss and all that. You have shown a gramophone in your walkthrough. Thank you for that. That really shows that you have really thought it through.
So we wanted to stick with the material that this user base likes up to. So we used up those elements.
Really good.
Good work. Good teamwork I see here. And one small thing, as a elderly and if as a patient also, garden and that thing, kitchen garden and producing your own sort of vegetables is all good, but certain patients won't be allowed to do that. And also lot of vegetation also invite lot of pollination, insects, and it is also hazardous for patients with respiratory diseases. So that's another layer, I would say, another stage. But good effort and all the best.
Thank you.
In among all five, I think this was the fully architecture pegged, you know, presentation, architecturally. I like three, you know, three elements very much, so I'll highlight those ones. First was the kitchen garden, obviously, and your research on the kitchen garden. Second was meditation center in the basement. It was something good. Maybe you need to, you know, work out some more on it. Third, your placing of the blocks, what you did in zigzag blocks. Those are actually good, you know. It has its own USP.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
That will definitely, we'll discuss maybe sometime later. But all the best. It's really good.
Good job. The clusters sort of reflect the vernacular architecture of that particular thing. Probably it could have been opened up a little bit to the kitchen garden. Probably would have given more vibrance to that, and there would have been more connect. Because I see my father also is very much interested in gardening. He's around 75. I see little bit of shortage. You've just been there. The next step you're not taken in. So probably the kitchen garden should have little bit that accessibility and the openness to that would have made it much, much more interesting. Then the aspect of the library. The library can be, you have thought of something interesting with the meditation hall. The library falls short. And I do see that there is no barrier. You have this ramp and there is a sudden dip. And suddenly you do not have any sort of a barrier. What if the person tends to go to the edge and fall off or something like that? These are minor details. I was trying to see even if it is there in your detailed model. It is not there. You have to think of how you can create the barrier. And think of how meditation can be much, much more interesting. What if it could have been elevated, gone up? You had a hill at the background.
Yes.
You have not capitalized the view of the hill. What if the library opens up to that? You had the very interesting vista, people just go, it's a very relaxing pole. And when you talked about the grid, I don't know what is the grid size and shape and how did it really evolve? What is the basis for formation of the grid? What is the dimension of the grid? Has to be understood. So that's something modular, which things start evolving from that. And we need to understand on what basis did it evolve, right? And how about these four roads abutting the site? Is it there as it is on the thing?
Sir, it's existing.
What happens in the surrounding?
Sir,
of course, it may be a new layout or something like that.
Yes, sir. Sir, it's now a developing area, a whole residential patch, which will be now emerging in this few years. So, currently there are no residences around, so it's an open patch to this.
So, good job overall done. What I really like about your presentation is, so a lot of times as architects we have very good designs, but it's equally important to convey the idea. On that ground you were perfectly there. And your presentation was designed in a way that the client would not lose interest, right? So that way it was very much there. And the best part of the presentation was, so your idea revolved around reflection and all. And everything was connected. So the music that you chose was also, you know,
yes,
supporting your idea. So that was really good. What I feel missing in that is, or what I feel can be improved, is the connections. So there are a lot of areas which are very far away from the entrance. So the person would have to travel around a lot. So probably those are the things. And like sir mentioned, the barrier. Around the temple, you have a ramp and then you can fall down.
Yes.
So little things here and there, but I really like your approach towards presentation, and I feel that you have really worked out all the details, connection to the vernacular setup, and because of the way you guys are presented, I would offer you the same thing that I've offered to the second group. come to Chandigarh, present it to students there. I'm offering you this because, see, through peer you learn a lot. And if you guys have done something really good, I would want other students to see that, right? So we can fix up a thing when both the teams can come together and we can have an official setup there, right? Good job.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, good job done. What are the name of you two people? You didn't speak throughout the presentation. Your name is?
Rahul. He's Rahul. He's Ashish. Aditya, and I'm Omkar.
So we decided to keep it that way so that the message which is being.
I was just kidding.
So because we two are going to speak and they two are.
Background, huh?
Yeah, that's the reason.
Okay, good. I had a similar point which sir also mentioned. The meditation hall could have been a bit elevated, lower probably. You need to have more height when you need to go into the meditation spaces. What your section showed was a little less height because everybody might not be sitting on the floor. There might be people who are sitting or using a wheelchair.
So the height provided was about 2.5. So would
just that your section, how the library correlated with the meditation area in that sense. And then you have shown the contours of the site. So what's the contour?
So it's 1 meter fall each contour.
1 meter for each.
So it totally gradually slopes down to 4 meter fall.
4 meter fall over a span of 500 odd meters, I guess.
Almost. So like from the last section that we showed. This section, sir, right from the entrance, the reception to the kitchen garden, it's gradually slopes down to approximately 4 meters.
And one thing which all the groups, I guess, missed was that how are you connecting to the localities? How are you connecting to your only one group mentioned that they are having a pond on the next site and then they are correlating to that, connecting to that. So you people need to address that issues when you come to practical fields. So start looking at those aspects as well. And I think you have been given 30 packs or 30 units?
30 units.
30 units.
Overall 36 units. 36
units. Not people.
No.
Not
no.
People.
No, no.
36 units. Fine.
Yeah, hi. Really good presentation, the video format, as well as the model making exercise. Also explanation just in place.
Thank you.
And the design also works around the whole concept is in place. Very good. I have two issues. One is that the crossover passages which you have in the hospital to the housing areas are too large and they're not even covered. And pergolas do not stop rain. There are very great chances of these people slipping, falling. They really can't cross over. You need to have covered connections in buildings which matter. And second thing is that I think this is a take home for all the students. It's a community living space. When you use temple as a word instead of a prayer room, I feel as an architect there's a limitation because there is a Jain community, there's a Muslim community, there are Buddhists. Wait, let me just finish. Then there are Christians. You need to call it a prayer room.
Yes.
And give emphasis of that form as a prayer room and not limited to a, because then you have to define the temple, what kind of temple it is. You do have a temple right in the front. So do connect these clusters also. They also need connection because otherwise they're becoming their cohorts. So that community living essence should also come through. But it is in place. It is functional, it's viable, it looks good. Thanks.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Good presentation. I think you are the only ones who have come with a model and everything. So, you know, and I think what I have learned, you know, as working with architects, I am not an architect, I am a doctor, is that unless you do this, you don't get the, you know, nowadays there is Revit and all, so probably yes, but this really helps you to, you know, understand what you are doing actually. So this is very, very important and I am quite glad that, you know, someone attempted that. So that brings us to the end of, you know, the competition. Give us 5-10 minutes, okay? If you guys want, you know, you just go around and have a round. It's already now closing down, so I don't know whether, you know. Already closed. Okay. So give us 10 minutes, you know. Start, you know, with your mala if you want. And don't cry. I mean, you can cry with happiness.